Hello everyone, welcome back to Aerohub and welcome to the series of lectures in aircraft structural design. And in the previous lecture we discussed about the weight estimation of wing for commercial as well as fighter aircraft, and also we discussed about the load transfer in the wing as well as the elements of the wing and its function. And in this lecture we will discuss about aileron geometry. And you are aware that ailerons are control surfaces that is mainly used for rolling of the aircraft. Okay, and this aileron plays a major role in flap characteristics as well as fin or rudder design. Okay, so to estimate the characteristic or select the flaps, we have to first of all select the aileron characteristics. Then it also affects the fin as well as rudder design. Okay, so fin, as you know, it is a part of the vertical stabilizer that avoids or reduces the rudder lock. Okay, it's called dorsal fin. And rudder, you are aware what is in the rudder. And now we will discuss about one of the important design criteria for aileron, that is called aileron volume constant. Aileron volume constant. Okay, so capital V subscript capital A, it's equal to 0.5 SA into LA divided by SB, where capital S is the wing area, smaller B is the wingspan, and SA is the total area of the aileron, and LA is nothing but the distance between the midpoint of ailerons. Okay, as you are aware that we have two ailerons for an aircraft, we have inboard and outboard ailerons, and you can see here, you can see or you can imagine that we will be having, for example, I can draw here, I have an aircraft, the front view. So let imagine we have our aileron here. Okay, this is a midpoint of one aileron, and this is a midpoint of second aileron, and the distance between these two midpoint is called the distance LA. Okay, I repeat, the distance between the midpoint of aileron is the distance L in L subscript A. Okay, now we'll discuss about different aileron characteristics. Okay, this aileron characteristic depends upon the engine of the aircraft. We have, as you are aware, that we have different types of engine we can use for aircraft applications, and the selection of aileron depends upon, and selection as well as sizing of the aileron depends upon the engine characteristics of the aircraft. As you can see in this particular table, we have single engine general and single engine aggregate. These are different types of aircraft. Okay, I'm not reading out the entire slide. And you can see here we have BA by B. Okay, BA is nothing but the total span of one set of aileron. Okay, and that divided by the smaller B is nothing but the span of the wing. Okay, BA upon B is nothing but the total span of one set of aileron divided by the span of the entire wing. And we have CA is the average aileron chord, and C bar is nothing but the geometry chord of the wing. So geometry chord of the wing can be estimated by C bar is equal to the wing span divided by the wing area, SB by S. Okay, so C bar is nothing but the wing span by wing area. We have the formula. So CA is nothing but the average aileron chord, and YA is nothing but the semi span distance between midpoint of aileron, that is I have already discussed. Okay, this one is nothing but YA is nothing but the distance between the two aileron, midpoint of two aileron. For example, we have the midpoint of aileron here, this is the midpoint of another aileron, so this will be the distance YA or LA. Okay, same as LA of the previous slide. Okay, and total SA by S. SA is nothing but the total area of the aileron divided by S. Okay, so we have certain ratio, certain values for different types of aircraft. We have a fighter aircraft, we have SA by S is 0.04. So similarly, we have different values for different aircraft. Okay, so these are design standard. We have to follow this design standard while designing the aileron characteristics or aileron. Okay, so and VA is nothing but the total aileron volume constant, and we have this value also having a certain constant value for different types of aircraft. Okay, so you have to consider all these factors while designing the aileron of a wing. Okay, so this is about this lecture. Thank you for listening. Take care.